Hey folks, this is Kalani. With the recent complaints of Blizzard basically plugging their ears and hoping for the best, it looks like we might see the earplugs actually come out now and again, as Ian decided to set up an AMA over on the WoW subreddit, which had a whole bunch of questions just ready to be answered, or dodged, but I'm actually pretty surprised about how many questions were answered and how long some of the responses were, even if they weren't necessarily what players wanted to hear. Let's have a look at some of the questions and answers from the AMA and go over some of the changes we might be able to expect in the near future. We had a question which asked about various facets of the Azeroth armor system. Why can an item level upgrade be a DPS downgrade? What are you going to do about underwhelming traits? How is this ever going to be more fun in the future? That sums up the questions pretty nicely, and the answer that Ian gave boiled down to, we kinda get that some of the Azeroth traits aren't that great, but we're pretty happy with how the unlocking mechanic is working so far. If you were hoping for some changes to the required amulet levels to unlock certain rows of traits on higher item level gear, you're probably going to be disappointed. They're pretty happy with how the AK catch-up mechanic is working as well, allowing you to progress faster and faster through your amulet levels as the weeks go by. But Ian did mention that a lot of the issues with item level upgrades not being an upgrade is definitely due to tuning, which they're going to be looking at pretty closely over the next few weeks. So I would expect a lot of the less exciting traits to get a bit of a bump, and some of the favourite traits right now, like Thunderous Blast, should see a bit of a nerf. Several traits that are just downright boring are also going to be removed from the game and replaced with a few better alternatives, so definitely keep your eye out for some new traits popping up on your existing armour, and be sure to thoroughly check through any new drops after these changes go live. Hopefully we'll end up with some interesting choices and be in a situation where an item level upgrade is typically an actual upgrade for your character, but I'm wondering what the dev team can come up with to replace these boring traits. They already had quite a long time to make sure the Azeroth traits that made it into the game were interesting enough to care about, and that didn't really end up all too well. I also don't think this is a system which can be easily balanced, so I wonder what the best traits are going to end up being after all is said and done. Because there's going to be some at the top and some at the bottom, but the difference between those two doesn't have to be as large as it is right now. And then of course, someone asked about Island Expeditions, their lack of rewards and repetitive gameplay. Ian's response basically said islands are a new type of content and they didn't get off to a super amazing start, but they're working on new events to try and keep things more interesting and to increase the variance of the islands overall, which is great to hear, but not particularly unexpected. He also said they've heard the feedback of the go-go-go gameplay, with everything being a race and the islands just lacking a reason to actually explore them, which is apparently just a side effect of having the faction conflict be a strong focus on the islands. Because the other faction is there, it's literally just a race to collect as much Azeroth as you can, because of the competitive side of islands they have to be inherently speedy. Which I wouldn't really agree with. Just because you have an enemy to work against, that doesn't mean everything has to become a race. If you reduced the amount of monsters that spawned on the islands and made all of the rewards significantly higher, but rarer overall, you would have to plan out your moves a little more. You couldn't just pull the entire island and kill it as quickly as possible. You might have to do a bit of searching for the right rewards and make sure the opposite faction doesn't claim the better rewards first. I think you could slow down islands while maintaining the competitive feel, but I guess that's not what the dev team has in mind. In other island news, there's going to be a hotfix to make all of the cosmetic rewards from islands like pets and mounts drop more often, so that's a nice little change at least. But islands aren't the only type of content that's been having issues recently. Warfronts have been a pretty large source of frustration for a lot of players, and especially for the Alliance so far in Battle for Azeroth, because they have yet to step foot in the scenario proper. One Reddit user asked if the large downtimes were intended, because having nothing to do relating to this super awesome new piece of content is kind of weird and not all too exciting. The reply doubled down on pretty much everything involving the cycle, which Ian said should end up being around 3.5 weeks instead of 4, but a few days either side probably won't mean too much in the long run. He acknowledged that the way Warfronts were going to work wasn't really communicated or explained all that well, but for the most part, the Warfronts will continue on their lengthy time cycles, mainly to give everyone a chance to contribute and play through the little section available in any given cycle quarter. Obviously, that doesn't really address any of the concerns or fix any of the issues, But he did also mention that more Warfronts are planned, which should give players more to do through each cycle, because they'll always have an active contribution or scenario phase when an extra Warfront becomes available. Personally, I think they should have had 2 Warfronts from the start. At least then everyone would have something to do, instead of having to wait and wait and wait and wait. It could have also helped to tell a few stories that's happening on the mainland while we're all off fighting for the Zandalarian Kulturans, because right now the war doesn't really seem to have spread too far. And then we also had a question about the Mythic Plus weekly cash, why we didn't see the 3-item chance this past week, and how we're going to earn Azerite armor from Mythic Plus a little more reliably. Because let's be honest, having the Azerite armor stripped from the loot table in Mythic Plus dungeons seems kind of lame. Not only is several traits and armor pieces sort of worthless to a lot of players until the aforementioned changes and fixes come around, but there's also no reliable way to get the pieces of armor you actually want at a higher item level. This answer was kind of interesting, because we found out about another mini feature which hadn't been explained or communicated at all. There's apparently going to be bad luck protection applied to Azerite armor from your weekly Mythic Plus cash. So if you don't get a piece of Azerite armor, your chance of getting a piece of Azerite armor the next week increases. This could be a great thing and an absolutely terrible thing at the same time. As the weeks go by, you're guaranteed to get 1 or 2 pieces of Azerite armor thanks to the bad luck protection. If you still need those pieces of Azerite armor, that's probably going to be a great item for you, but if you don't need Azerite armor from Mythic Plus anymore, you're going to be constantly fed Azerite armor pieces eventually, because there's no way to opt out that bad luck protection, and you can only get 1 item every week. I can see this being pretty cool if the changes to Azerite armor and traits end up making us care more about the system as a whole, but if we're going to receive more Azerite armor that just isn't worth using, that could become quite frustrating. I still think it would be a better idea to just plop Azerite armor back onto the Mythic Plus loot table and have it looted like any other item, but from Ian's response, it seems like the dev team actually want Azerite armor to be a bit scarce. You only have 1 chance per boss in raids to get the armor pieces you need, and you're heavily restricted when it comes to obtaining Azerite armor from dungeons. So it seems like they don't want us to have easy access to the Azerite armor pieces that are good for us. I guess we'll just have to get used to those 340 pieces for now until we hit the lottery and get the item we need from the weekly Mythic Plus cash. And there was also a question about alt progression, asking about the Heart of Azeroth artifact power and reputations. It seems like the artifact power catcher mechanic that increases every week is the only thing we're going to get for a little while to come, which is fine with me. I think the system worked very well in Legion and works even better in Battle for Azeroth, because you're not getting to crazy numbers like 1 billion artifact power from a single world quest. The progress seems to be fairly slow after you hit a certain point though, especially on your main character. I can't imagine an alt ever really catching up without doing an absurd amount of extra content, which might be a pretty big problem for a lot of people. I'm just thankful that we actually have a catch-up mechanic from the amulet right from the get-go, instead of having to wait for a few months, and when you log onto an alt, you're already caught up with it. As for reputation, it looks like we just aren't going to see account-wide rep this side of a next expansion. Ian made the same comment that I remember from one of the earlier Q&As, why do you feel the need to have exalted reps on your alts as well as your mains? To which a lot of people replied with various answers, such as wanting to change character or class but feeling tied down to their main character because of all the reputations they have at exalted, as well as reputations from different characters not counting towards large meta achievements, and even reputations limiting their ability to use certain transmogs from tabards or faction-based gear sets. Reputations are a pretty huge reason why I struggled to change characters back when I was playing on EU servers, and when I eventually did decide that I wanted to play something else, I felt absolutely compelled to grind out all the reputations I already had, just because I wanted everything on my main character. That's probably not an issue a lot of players have because they're not weird, but account-wide reputation would still be a nice addition to the game, or at least having something to help speed up rep farming on alts once your main is exalted would be a fantastic compromise, just like the Mists of Pandaria commendations. And we'll finish on a quick one. Someone asked about the Paragon system for reputations in Legion. Where did it go and will it be coming back? The answer to that question is a most definite yes. We will see the Paragon reward system return for Battle for Azeroth reputations, so you can farm up past Exalted for some, fingers crossed, awesome goodies. But that begs the question of where it's been until now and why we don't see it until the next patch. If people are already hitting Exalted, surely having a reward for all of that extra rep can only be a good thing, right? Well, it may be a case of giving everyone who isn't already exalted a little bit more time to get there before everyone else starts farming up pets, mounts, or whatever else the dev team decides to include in this round of rewards. It might also be the dev team allowing us to feel finished and done with reputation for a little while, so there's absolutely no incentive to keep grinding our faces against world quests and the like to try and get the Paragon rewards before everyone else. Whether it's a force break from rep farming or not, a break is always nice and then, and hopefully the next patch isn't too far away anyways. Speaking of the next patch, I believe we should see something on the PTR fairly soon, and there's a developer livestream on Tuesday the 18th which is going to detail exactly what the next patch is going to bring us. We're not sure if this is going to be patch 8.1 yet, but that's what I would put my money on. I'm super excited to see where Battle for Azeroth goes from here. I just hope there's a little bit of spare time dedicated to improving some of the issues that weren't fully addressed in the AMA. I'll link the AMA in the comments section below so you can peruse the questions and answers at your own leisure. There's a few other questions which I didn't cover which might be of interest to you. What do you think of the AMA altogether? How did it go? What about Ian's responses? How about the promise of new exciting Azerite traits? Leave all your thoughts in the comments section below. A big thank you to all of our supporters over on Patreon. You can see their names floating by on screen. If you want to join these lovely guys and gals, you can find a link in the description below. Remember to leave a like just below the video before you leave, and if you want to see more, make sure to subscribe. But apart from that, thanks for watching, folks. Good luck and have fun, and as always, I will see you next time.